Hong Kong's so-called umbrella movement has been going on now for almost 3 weeks. And one of the really interesting things that we've observed is the spontaneous initiatives that just keep springing up. It could be the democracy wall, it could be umbrella art, as it's known. But the more recent one that we've seen are the student desks. And here we have an array of them. And they really have come out of nowhere. Volunteers just came along and set them up. They're free for students to use, and students get priority. In fact, there's a sign here saying student first. But it does say welcome to use, and people have come, they're sitting here doing their work. This gentleman here, for example, his name is Chris. He's a chemistry student. He's been coming here off and on now for more than 2 weeks. And he gets his work done here. And I asked him, do your professors support what you're doing? They said, yes, absolutely. They give me the work. I come down here, I get it done. In fact, just today, a PhD student came along and offered him one-to-one tuition, which he's very grateful for. I did ask him what he would do if the police came along and said, okay, it's time to move on now. And he said, unless our demands are met, this demand for universal suffrage, we're not going anywhere. And we are not organized. He doesn't see himself as being led by any one student movement. Someone here is reading a recipe book, but people are here doing different things, catching up on different aspects of their work. But what's really interesting about this is this area is really in the heart of what's left of the protest zone in Hong Kong's Admiralty. It's on Hong Kong Island, it's part of the Central Business District. It's very calm, people feel safe here, and it really is a real change and an irony if you look at the scuffles that are going on the periphery. When you see this, the atmosphere juxtaposed against that, you wonder how long the police can maintain that fine balance between the two. Manisha-Tank, CNN, Hong Kong.